This is all brand new stuff. And I got to tell you, I'm getting to watch it happen. I'm seeing the pencils. I saw the scripts. It's so exciting. And we are so happy to have, Matt Rowe on board. Matt Rowe, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Thanks for the amazing intro. Happy to be here.
when you sent us your submission, yeah. One of the things I'm going to say now, and we'll talk about it after though, is Matt's variety, the variety of what Matt can draw is incredible. We were so taken with you. When you go through your hit list, through mm-hmm. the stuff that you've made, and it's not like you're saying, oh yeah, he does this thing. No, not at all. You do all kinds of things and you do them all well. So this is really exciting for us. So let's start at basics. Who the heck are you?
Well, like I said, I'm Matt Rowe. I'm a comic creator from London, Ontario, Canada. You might know me from my work on Nightmare Man. I have a new book coming out on Kickstarter this August called The Eternal Dieback. Looking forward to that one. And like Christian mentioned, jack of all trades. Do it yourself, right? That's what comics are about, really.
So do you mean by that that you also write and letter and... Yep. Yeah. And now you've written a couple, if I remember correctly, that you have out already.
Yeah. I've written, I think I started way back in 2015 through a local indie publisher called RP Publications. And it was for my creator-owned dark superhero book called The Deviation Vivid. And I wrote and illustrated that on my graduating year in video game design. And the whole team classmates, I guess, were floored that I was able to keep up with all the assignments, the end of the year shit, and there's the swearing, and put together a whole comic book.
What are you doing for Containment Breach?
I'm doing a story with Grant DeArmit, I believe. I hope I didn't butcher his last name there. We're doing a story called Olympus. It's a bit of a horror story, mythical, following this guy named Alex and how he's coming to terms with the passing of his father and the legacy that his father left behind that he may not want to continue. There's a lot of mysteries and surprises, I suppose, to find out with it. It's a bit of a thriller. It's based in a theme park, actually. Rundown old theme park. I've been really enjoying drawing the roller coasters and all that kind of stuff.
And you got to do, when you're drawing this, you got to do a ton of research, right? For
image, oh yeah,
right. So Gabe Martini is mm-hmm. on this book, working with one of our editors, actually, Dustin Luke Nelson. And mm-hmm. Dustin wrote this really great story, but Gabe said there's a pregnant woman in it. So Gabe had to do all this research just to see how the belly falls, right, and all that.
Yep.
And then, so suddenly the internet thinks he's a pregnant woman. And he said it took about 2 weeks for his internet ads to get back to the stuff he actually likes. And I know I've done that to James yep. Lyons, co-founder of Fugitive Poems. I yep. had him in our first comic we did together, River. I had him bisect a face, just like a cross section of a face. And yeah. He's a perfectionist. So he's got hanging around his office all these things he's printed out from the internet of cross section face. His son comes into the office like, Dad, what the hell are you doing? He's like, it's Christian's fault.
Yep.
But thanks to those drawings, I didn't realize how high up the sinuses were. And now mm-hmm. I know why I feel like such crap in my brain when I have a cold. So I learned something from killing a fictional character.
It is. It's wild the things that you can learn just from looking up research on a story. I remember I wanted to get some unique looking skulls for a past work. And one of the coolest skulls that I stumbled across was an owl skull. I don't know if anyone's Googled owl skulls, but they are some wild looking things.
Everyone has just hit pause or opened up.
Yeah.
Owl skulls. All right, now I'm going to be checking that out immediately.
Right?
We're so glad to have you on this book. There's Grant is an incredible writer.
Oh yeah.
Grant's working on like four different levels at once. There's this deep empathy in everything he writes, but it's also wild fun. And that's not something everybody can put together.
Yeah.
Full three-dimensional characters. And that was one of the things that we saw in your art, James and I, was that you bring that depth to your art as well. Your characters are three-dimensional. You can see in the expressions and even in the poses and in the rendering. And so we thought that you two would have a lot of fun together and really bring out whatever was going on with those characters.
Yeah, I couldn't be happier to be paired up with Grant, to be honest. I think one of the first times we connected was over email, and I knew right away that he was a good dude. He was talented. I'd seen some of his previous work. I gave him my phone number just so we could stay in touch, and he's been texting me off and on all throughout the process. I've been showing him some things. He's been showing me some things. And yeah, it's been great. He'll message me on the weekend apologizing about, sorry to get in touch with you about work during the weekend. I'm like, no, man, comics are made on the weekends, after work, middle of the night, whenever you got time, right? Yeah.
Yep. Your influences, would you say are your big influences?
Ah, geez. I think I got into comics reading Greg Capullo's work on Batman, the New 52 run. Yep.
Rap.
Yeah.
Oh, talk about a pairing, right?
Yeah.
He just got what Scott Snyder was doing.
Mm-hmm.
It just, you got owls in there as well.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And then, yeah, just from him, it was Frank Miller and Jim Lee and all kinds of guys. Geez, look at my shelf. Yeah, just about. Everyone has something to offer, I think, and I try to study a lot of different work, to be honest. Whether it is the art or it's the storytelling, there's a local writer around here, local writer artist actually, Jeff Lemire. He's in Ontario, and his stories are something else. If you've ever picked up one of his books, I think he just had something on Netflix from a comic, Sweet Tooth.
Jeff Lemire.
Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't hear you right. Jeff Lemire,
yeah.
As far as writers go, I'm is one of my heroes.
Super talented dude.
His art too, Frog Catchers. I put down Frog Catchers and just sat for 20 minutes in it.
It's funny you say that one, because if anyone asks me to recommend them a book or graphic novel, I always recommend Frog Catchers. I'm like, it is one to get you thinking. To say the least.
Oh man, the development of that storyline. The other one I love that he did was Sentient for TK.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That was terrific. You're frozen again. I don't know if I'm going to lose you. And I'm the Descender Ascender series is amazing.
I haven't dug into that one, but from what I've seen, it's stunning.
Descender is a masterpiece. And what he's doing with Ascender, it's all one. It's not an arc, it's a circle, I think.
I'm going to have to check that out.
Oh, my. Yeah. Anything. Lemire can put, if Lemire puts his name on it, I'd buy a roll of toilet paper. I mean, just.
Yeah. I feel the same way.
Matt, this was a pleasure. Thank you for taking the time to hang out for what was absolutely not a 3-minute interview. I can't wait to talk to you again. Anything that you wanna throw out there again before we end?
Check out mattrowart.com and look forward to Olympus by Matt Rowe and Grant Diarmit on the Fugitive Poems next Containment Breach.
Containment Breach Volume 2.
Yes,
Volume 2. Kickstarter in the fall. Keep your electric eye on us, as David Bowie said. I love that line. fugitivepoems.com. Subscribe. I'll get back to writing blog posts at the end of this video. If I have figured out how to put a link to another site on it, click on that. If not, go to our Kickstarter, to our webpage. That'll take you to our Kickstarter pre-launch. Get on there. This thing, I have a feeling this is gonna go fast. And I've only got one story in the book. I'm saying that because of the unbelievable amount of talent we have, like Mr. Matt Rowe right here. I'm Christian DiMatteo. We are Fugitive Poems. and we make comics.